In the mid-1950s, while the West was still celebrating the British Comet and preparing the Boeing 707, the Soviets made a bold move. This is the Tupolev Tu-104, the world's second jet airliner and the first to enter sustained passenger service. It didn't just carry passengers, it carried a message. The USSR had entered the jet age. When it debuted in 1956, the Tu-104 stunned the world. It was fast. It was powerful. And it was adapted directly from a bomber, the Tupolev Tu-16. Yes, you heard that right. Where Boeing was designing a jetliner from scratch, the Soviets repurposed a nuclear-capable bomber into a passenger jet. It could fly at 870 kilometers per hour, with up to 50 passengers initially, later more. Aeroflot's Tu-104 soon dominated routes across the Soviet Union, Eastern Europe, and even to cities like London and Beijing. It was a symbol of Soviet power, sleek, fast, and ahead of its time. But flying on the Tu-104 wasn't exactly smooth sailing. The aircraft had a reputation for being unforgiving. Its heavy controls, poor stall characteristics, and bomber heritage made it a challenging ride, especially in bad weather. Still, it worked, and it shocked the West into accelerating jetliner development. For nearly a decade, the Tu-104 remained the only jet airliner in regular service, until the Boeing 707 and Douglas DC-8 arrived. But by then it had proven its point. By the early 1970s, it was retired. But its legacy? Permanent. The Tupolev Tu-104 was more than just a plane. It was the jet that put the Soviet Union in the commercial aviation race and showed the world that jet travel was no longer a Western dream. It was a reality on both sides of the Iron Curtain. If you enjoyed this Cold War classic, don't forget to like, subscribe, and check out our full series, Airliners That Changed the World, and subscribe for more.